I don't like the sound of that at all.
We have one right here. This is actually a small one.
The flavor is cricket.
Is there another story? Cricket. Cricket?
Whoa! Hey everyone, my name is Philip Wang. Welcome to Spill the Boba Tea, a show where I bring friends over to my cafe, Bopomofo, after hours for a special, exclusive, and private drink making session where we come up with a beverage that is completely unique and inspired by my guest's life and career. Today, we have Ross Butler with us. Yeah, but you might know him. You might know him as Nathan Pierce from Teen Wolf, Reggie Mantle from Riverdale, Zach Dempsey from 13 Reasons Why, Trevor from the To All the Voice trilogy, and Ian Yorita from a single episode of Major Crimes.
Come on. Man.
I had to go pretty deep in the IMDb for that.
Okay.
Do you remember that?
That was my first ever.
That's your first credit.
My first credit.
What was the episode about?
I was an Asian American teenager in high school that was a drug dealer, but I also got accepted into Stanford.
Okay.
So I was like a smart drug dealer.
Got it. So you're a high schooler. That was when the high school started for you. You've been in high school for 15 years since.
Yes. I've been in high school since I was actually 14.
Yeah.
And now I'm like turning 31 in a week.
That's a good run, man. That's a good run.
Yeah, 17 years.
Well, today we are at my cafe and we're gonna be making a very special drink that is completely unique to you.
Ooh.
I did my research. I have a lot of every ingredient here and some that I have hidden are related to your life or career.
I'm kind of scared, dude.
Have you ever made a boba drink before?
No.
All right, what's your first memory of boba? Or you're from the East Coast, so.
Yeah.
Do you call it bubble tea or boba?
Bubble tea. Bubble tea was...
Guys, cut the cameras. We can't continue.
Listen, I've lived here for 10 years. I'm a West Coaster now.
Yeah, okay,
I don't associate with the East Coast anymore. Actually, back then, there wasn't a ton of bubble tea. I definitely haven't made any. I don't know if that's like a normal thing that if you don't own a cafe...
Yeah.
Do people make boba tea like in their kitchen?
You know what? I think the pandemic inspired a lot of people to start. The first ingredient we actually have here is inspired actually by the fact that you grew up in Indonesia, in Southeast Asia.
Yeah.
Jakarta. But you were born in Singapore.
Yes.
Your mother's Chinese Malaysian.
Yes.
You have the Southeast Asian region on lock.
Yeah, I represent a lot of countries down there.
Right. So this is actually a jackfruit puree. Have you ever seen a jackfruit before?
Yes.
We have one right here. This is actually a small one.
Yeah, no, I love these little babies.
Like, do you do curls with these?
That's a little light, you know.
It's a little light, yeah.
This is a good one.
So, I mean, that's your parting gift. We can put that to the side there later. You can actually take that if you
is
want.
It?
Yeah. Your new little baby, yeah, you came out to St. Gabriel.
Actually, no, I actually love that. Yeah, I'm gonna keep that right there.
Perfect.
No, durian is like one of my favorite fruits. And I know it's the same, but it's a lot more dangerous than this.
Little bit, yeah.
Yeah, the spikes are.
So we made a puree out of it.
Awesome.
So we're gonna start off with 3 1-ounce scoops. That's
three
ounces.
Okay.
All right, so we're just gonna go straight into the bottom of the cup.
You've never made this unique mixture of...
So I'll be honest with you, we tried it yesterday. You know what, we'll see what happens. You know what I mean? That's plenty. I think that's good.
I like jackfruit, okay.
All right, yeah. I was gonna say I got the jackfruit because we got a jacked guy here.
For good measure.
Just gotta
get more jacked.
So yeah, I mean, growing up in Indonesia, you were there for how long before you moved?
Four or five years.
Yeah. What's your most vivid memory of Indonesia? Do you remember like a crush that you had on like a girl on the street or something?
When I was two?
No, when you were four or five.
I remember having like a girlfriend in first grade, but like Sydney Goodham.
If she's out
there watching this, I'll never forget the name, Sydney Goodham.
Does she have any idea that you had a crush on her?
No, it was official. Sydney Goodham and I,
we were
going steady.
The next ingredient that we're gonna put in here is actually gonna be the boba balls. We're actually gonna go right into the boba balls, but you'll notice that there's only 13. One for each reason. That's a 13 Reasons Why reference, by the way, in case you guys missed that.
Is that even a reference? That's just, okay.
It's very on the nose.
At 13, is 13 a lot of boba to be putting in a
13's
drink?
13's very little.
I was going to say, like,
dude,
I
don't... Well, I also know that, you know, it's like a health thing. Maybe you don't want to go too hard on the complex carbs.
Listen, if I'm going to go for boba, I'm going to go for boba.
I mean, we'll put the 13 in for now.
You could have at least put in, like, 52. 50? One for each season of 13.
You're right. Ross, you play Zach Dempsey on 13 Reasons Why.
I do.
3 seasons. You know, you mentioned now that you've been a high schooler for a while. A lot of those high school roles have also been the jock. Lacrosse, basketball, football.
Yeah, baseball.
Baseball. How many of those sports were you actually playing in high school?
None.
None.
None of those.
Were you not even a jock in high school?
No, I was not. I played tennis in high school. So,
are you serious? Wait, are you serious?
Yeah.
Can we play sometime?
Yeah, dude. I mean, I used to play competitively for like.
Oh, okay, maybe we shouldn't.
No,
play
but I've also haven't played in like 15 years.
Okay, so maybe now we're even.
Yeah. All right. I got to pick it back up.
Okay, but. Sounds good. So I'm guessing, do you not relate that much to your jock characters like Zach?
No, not really. The reason why I like Zach is because he's kind of like a nice jock.
Versus some of the other, yeah.
The mean jocks on the show. Like Reggie is a mean jock, but we love him because he's just. Dick. But Zach is just like a nice jock.
Right.
He's like a good example for how a high school athlete should act.
Right.
Most of the time.
The other thing about your character is that you're a heartthrob in this show too.
Yes.
And in real life, not just the show, okay?
Just the show. I'm a fake heartthrob.
I was gonna say, in actual high school, did you get that same heartthrob treatment?
Yeah, you know, to be honest, not really.
You had a girlfriend in first grade that didn't carry
and
over.
I peaked in first grade. Ever since Sydney Goodhand, that was the pinnacle.
I'm so sorry.
It was downhill from there.
Oh, dang, that's a...
No, I mean, I had like a girlfriend or two in high school, and I wasn't like a jock, or I wasn't like the cool kid, but I wasn't like, you know, I think it's because I grew up different that I had to develop social skills to fit in.
Okay.
So I like to think so. Yeah. So I would just kind of float around from social group to social group. And yeah.
So you were widely accepted, but like you didn't have like one particular identity.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, widely welcomed into the, but I just was like a floater.
The next ingredient
that
we have here is actually some soy milk.
Okay.
Now, the reason why I chose soy milk is because you grew up in Virginia.
Yeah.
In Fairfax, Virginia.
Yeah.
Did you know that soybeans are a major agricultural product of Virginia? I didn't either until I had to do research for this show.
Also, I would have been concerned if you knew that about Virginia. If you're not from Virginia.
I know every state's
agricultural exports.
So here's what we're going to do. We're going to start off by pouring 250 cc's. There's some numbers here if you look really
closely. CCs, not milliliters?
Not milliliters, CCs. All right, oh, okay. You good, 250?
Yeah.
All right, cool. But here's the thing, you grew up in specifically in Fairfax.
Yeah.
And I just wanna make sure that you got your Fairfax facts straight. So we're going into a game right now. Simple questions, all right?
Jeez, I'm not gonna know.
Are you not gonna?
I'm not confident in this at all, but let's do it.
You grew up in Fairfax, Virginia. What is the capital of your state?
Richmond.
Are you sure?
Yes.
That's correct.
Yeah, I was just wait a second. I was actually scared there. I was just like, oh my God.
All right, Fairfax is part of the DC Metro area.
The DMV.
It's part of Nova, yeah, DMV.
Yeah.
If you wanted to take the DC Metro out to Fairfax, what line would you take?
Oh God.
Have you ever taken the DC Metro?
I have.
All right.
I have.
So just put yourself back on one of those drunken nights coming back from.
That's the trouble. It's because mostly they
were. Just.
I think the yellow line.
Ooh, you're in the right side of the spectrum.
Red.
The other one.
Blue.
No, the same. Orange.
Okay. I was almost there.
That's what I'm saying.
I kind of remembered
you're close.
My first two guesses. This is in between the first two guesses.
Last question of the Fairfax facts.
Why don't you just call it the Fairfax?
My show,
why
Ross.
Why you got to tag on another facts on the end?
Each February.
Okay.
Fairfax holds a special blank lovers festival.
See, Virginia's for lovers.
Yeah,
it's
blank lovers.
Virginia lovers. The Virginia Lovers Festival.
The Virginia Lovers Festival?
No.
It's in February.
It's the Valentine's of lovers.
Ugh, close enough.
The
Chocolate Lovers Festival.
How is it?
I don't know, you grew up there. You never went to the Chocolate Lovers Festival?
No!
Well, next time you go back, please check out
the Chocolate Lovers. I'm gonna go, sign me up.
All right. Now that we kind of know a little bit more about Fairfax and where you grew up, I want to know how your experience was growing up in Fairfax. You know, you essentially immigrated over here, right?
Yeah.
And also, yeah, like you said, it was kind of diverse, or how was it for you?
It was relatively diverse, but because it's DC, so, and I also went to like, you know, I went to school with like a lot of politicians' kids, but it was still predominantly white, and it was still like very white culture.
Yeah, yeah.
I've heard a lot of stories of like other kids being bullied for being Asian and stuff like that, and I never really got that. I never got bullied, but we still did deal with the stereotypes, and still like jokes were made, because back then it was just like they were thought of, they were harmless or innocuous. Like, you know, who cares if we're making this joke or that joke? So, yeah, I still never really felt like I belonged.
I see. I was gonna ask, like, you know, as a like biracial kid too, did that ever play a part in terms of like your struggle to find that identity or to understand who you were?
Yeah, no, absolutely. It's having like one foot, you know, with my white half, but not like fully feeling like I belong, because I just didn't look like them. Because if you look at me, obviously, like, I'm Asian.
Yeah,
some people think I'm full Asian, but then a lot of like the Asian kids there, it's a weird. Ironically, because there was an Asian population, I did, like, they could form their own clique, like, a lot of, and I wasn't a part of it. And that added to, like, what I said before, I just kind of floated around. It's that feeling of not being Asian enough to be Asian, you know, even though it's just like, I grew up with my mom and, you know, and I grew up in America, so. Yeah, it is a weird thing. I, like, even as a 30-year-old, like, I'm more confident in Asian American now, because this is like a very new emerging, not majority, but like a major minority group is like Asian American, and biracial people just mathematically are gonna happen more and more as time goes on.
You are the future,
Yeah, it's just like, I forgot what comedian said it, like Russell Peters, he's like, we're all gonna be beige.
All right, so Ross, you work out a lot.
I dabble.
In your workouts, obviously you have to take some protein sometimes, add a little protein to your shakes, right? Now, not a lot of people have ever done this before by putting protein in their boba drinks. I call it broba.
Broba tea.
We have some protein powder here.
Okay. What flavor?
The flavor is unique, actually.
Okay.
The flavor is cricket.
Is there another cricket? Cricket?
This is...
Like cheap cricket?
Cheap, but actually kind of expensive.
Well, yeah.
This is 100% ground cricket powder.
Okay.
Are you familiar that cricket is like a crazy source
super,
of protein?
Yeah, it's a super food.
Do you want to smell it?
Yeah.
Have you had this before?
No.
Smells like earth.
Smells like an Asian market.
Yeah.
Yeah, like an herb market.
I didn't want to just bring you regular whey protein, right?
So I
was like,
let's
you know, I think Ross is an adventurous guy.
Oh yeah.
So let's go for it. So we're gonna do one. This probably is one cricket, maybe.
That looks
way more because it's ground up.
That's got to be at least seven.
This is gonna be my first time like having any type of cricket.
No, I'm excited, but you look, you're getting a little pale over there.
All right, here we go. Bam! All right, one scoop for you, one scoop for you. Yeah.
I'm gonna do a heaping scoop.
Heaping scoop. All right, this guy wants the entire cricket family.
I need to get some protein. That's a lot of cricket.
That's a lot of cricket.
It's okay. Did you ever have that like shredded pork
stuff? Yeah.
That kind of reminds me.
Rosong. All right, so let's put that on. Make sure it's tight so we don't get cricket all over.
Wet cricket all over the place. Okay.
Shake. Very good. See?
I literally went to a mixology class yesterday.
Yeah, you know what to
do. It's like the shake.
All right, so here's the thing. What we were experimenting with earlier, this isn't like a protein that dissolves because it's just...
Because it's cricket. Because it's exoskeleton. It's going like this.
Yes, because we're eating exoskeletons, which are not supposed to dissolve.
Cool.
I didn't choose to, you know, bring up the protein for no reason. Like, you work out a lot. You have this persona, this larger than life persona. You play a superhero. You're like, you know, playing, you know, football stars. As an Asian male, like, how important are those types of roles to you? Like, do you ever think about it? Like, do you feel pressure that like, oh, I'm supposed to like offset this other stereotype? You know what I mean?
Yeah, no, you hit the nail on the head with that one. It's like, there's like, you know, Asian males are some of the only like gender race combination that has been like just emasculated through all of media for decades and decades and decades. Like, it's just so many stories of, like, you know, the Asian, like, Jet Li's, I forgot what movie it was, but he was supposed to, like,
Romeo Must Die,
and he was supposed to kiss the they cut the scene out of the movie just because, I mean, I'm not going to say why, but what we assume is just because they didn't want Asian men to seem like, you know, desirable.
Yeah, desirable.
It's one of my personal goals to just change the image of the Asian male, is that, like, we're not these scrawny little nerds that don't know how to talk to girls, and you know, because that's literally all the Asian characters when I was in high school. Like, that's all
that's
I
all
would
you
see.
Saw, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
And I think that's a tough thing too, because it's like, you know, we ultimately, I think we just want to be seen as, like, a spectrum of people. You know, like, I think, like, you know, when you think of, like, white actors and you see, you know, like, you see Seth Rogen, you're not like, oh, I guess every white person's like Seth
Rogen. Exactly.
Because they have Channing Tatum's, right? So we want that balance. Like, we can be quiet. We can be, you know, smart nerds, but we can also be this too. Yeah. Like, I think that's what we're striving for.
We can be all of it at the same time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so you're just representing that one.
You're representing
that side of the spectrum.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Because, I mean, I think we're fighting a lot of different battles of, like, representation, and it's just one part of the spectrum has been over exposed, where the other one has, like, not been.
So
at all.
Each like, you know, bench press is like, this is for the culture.
That's exactly why I work out, for the culture. The only reason.
That's a good motivation, honestly. Yeah.
Like, I know we're joking about it, but honestly, it really does. Like, you know, it does motivate me.
All right, so we're gonna put some ice in here because we want a nice refreshing drink.
Oh, you don't have any reason for the ice. You don't have a.
Well, that's just because you're so cool.
Okay, this is really nice looking ice.
Yeah. We're gonna do 2 ounces of sugar, and the sugar is because you're so sweet. There you go.
So 2 of these.
Just 2, yeah, 2 of the small. Yeah. One, so we're going for 2 ounces. I'm gonna go back and shake that up. Go for it. All right, so we're just gonna just go light. Try to hit a piece of ice so that it kind of, like, dissipates it. Oh my God, there's crickets in our drink.
This is weird to look at.
Wait, don't fill it all the way to the top. We need a little bit of room.
Okay, for more crickets.
Yeah.
You're gonna bring out, like, whole crickets.
We got some scorpions coming too. Yeah. We got one final ingredient, and it is activated charcoal.
Activated charcoal.
Yes. So have you ever seen this before?
No.
So the reason why I chose activated charcoal is because it's black, and you have a super suit that is also black.
Oh.
So we're gonna pour this right over. You're gonna same thing. Hit the top of an ice cube so that you can get...
That's funky looking.
Yeah, try that. Just a little bit.
Oh, you know,
hit the ice cube, there you go.
I get it now.
All right. It kind of looks like your suit. You got that yellow and the black.
That's actually kind of cool. Yeah, it's like the lightning bolt.
Exactly.
Oh, shit.
So you play Eugene in Shazam.
Yeah.
Could you have ever imagined when you first started that you'd be playing a superhero, especially as an Asian American?
Yeah. Honestly, it was always like a dream, but it was one of those dreams that you never really know if it's going to be possible because just the space isn't there. Like, there aren't characters. Like, of course, I'd done the research on all the Asian American superheroes and... Yeah. There's like Shang-Chi and Amadeus Cho and all these. But those weren't really being made back then.
Right.
And they weren't even in the conversation.
Not even close.
Yeah. Back when I was, you know, playing Ian Urita on Major Crimes, that was never, it was always something that I aspired to, but nothing that I thought was possible.
I just wonder, like, how do you feel, like, do you feel like pressure to, like, have to be a particular way, or are you just kind of like, hey man, just, like, let me just be who I am?
Yeah, I think there's pressure, not that it's, like, necessarily changing who I am, but I, of course, I do feel pressure of being careful of, like, you know, just setting a good example and just being a role model, because that is something that I've wanted to do, especially if I want to create change.
Yeah.
There is, like, a standard that we have to hold ourselves to, and I mean, not that that's a bad thing,
but it is, like, this feeling of, like, I talk about this with a lot of people where all that pressure shouldn't be on, like, one single person or one single character, like, where you have to feel like I represent the entire community, right? And thankfully, there are other now superheroes and other main characters that can kind of shoulder the weight along
with you. It's just showing that there are multiple facets of who we are. Right. There are multiple types of Asian superheroes.
Exactly.
There's ones that are more, you know, related to... the homeland, I guess, for lack of to our native culture,
exactly.
Than those ones that are more Asian American. Like, the thing about Eugene and Shazam is that he's not a martial artist. Right. You know, he's not like a stereotypical Asian. He's just an adopted Asian American kid. And then you have Shang-Chi, who's like martial art, and that's great because, you know, that's preserving part of our culture that makes us unique, and that should always be there. Yeah.
And that's that spectrum that we're talking about, right? We want to have more than just one, right? It should just be one.
Yeah.
The thing is, the drink is done, right? But we all know that you don't just go ahead right away to drink.
No.
You always got to take a selfie with it.
Okay.
And to all the boys, always and forever.
Okay.
There was a travel montage.
Yes, there was.
Of you taking food selfies all around the city.
Yep.
I'm gonna set the timer real quick.
This is a crazy device you got here.
Hey man, I came prepared. As if you're in the To All The Boys montage.
What face should I make? You tell me.
Hmm.
What should I be thinking of?
Do one thinking of Noah next to you, as if you're traveling with Noah. Like, let's put that into the montage.
Good old Noah.
Like, Noah's right there.
You can CG him in.
Yeah, we'll Photoshop him. Perfect. Now is the time for the moment of truth.
Okay.
We gotta drink this thing.
I'm nervous.
All right, these are bamboo fiber straws, by the way.
Oh,
100% biodegradable.
Okay.
Shout out to Cropsticks. All right, here we go. So we got to mix it up. You use the straw to mix it up.
That do anything for you?
I don't know. You got to make sure you get the jackfruit all mixed in there. Yeah.
It's actually mixing pretty well.
Ross, thank you so much for making this drink with me, inspiring this drink. I call this the Ross's Jacked Milk.
I don't like the sound of that at all.
Jackfruit. It's because it's jackfruit.
I don't like that at all.
And milk. That's why. I just heard it now.
I had a visceral response to that.
I just heard it. Let's just drink.
Let's just drink. Okay. All right.
We've never tried this. Whoa. Whoa, though.
Actually, not bad.
That's kind of nice.
Yeah, the jackfruit.
The jackfruit really plays with the milk, the soy milk.
Yeah.
Cause the soy milk's not like too thick.
Yeah, it's not too sweet.
Yeah.
I don't taste the cricket.
Yeah.
But I'm getting all that cricket protein.
Yeah.
You know?
We get all the benefits of it.
I've never had jackfruit boba or jackfruit
milk.
Milk.
Jacked milk.
No. saying it twice isn't gonna make it better.
All right, Ross. Hey, thank you so much for coming to my cafe.
Thank you, man. Thank you for the jackfruit.
Yes.
This was a good little chat, man.
I'm glad we got to catch up.
Yeah.
And you will always know that this is the Ross special at Bopomofo.
Yeah. So if I come in and I say, hey, can I?
See, now you want to. Now you want to ask for it.
Can I get one of my? Can I get one of my jacked milks?
Absolutely. Thanks for watching Spill the Boba Tea, everyone. Follow Ross. Links below, links everywhere. You already know where he is.
Come get my jacked milk, everyone.
We're gonna ship this to him. We're gonna ship this bottle to him.
Yeah.
It's gonna be great. Thanks so much, Ross.
Thank you, man.